Hello and welcome to the FCW podcast. Yes, I have taken over all of them now. I am here. I am your host, Billy. I am taking over the Fair City Wrestling podcast to preview ArdlerMania coming up this Saturday at the Ardler Complex on September 28th. I'm looking forward to this. Know why? Know why, people? Know why I have taken over this particular podcast from Patrick, from Cairn? It's because I'll be there. I'll be at this event. I will be on commentary duties. So I'm going to give you a rundown of all matches that have been announced as of recording. I'm looking forward to this. It's the first time I'll be doing commentary on an event live and in person. And a couple things in my own little office here that are on my Patreon, on Scott Resnett Patreon. But this is going to be the first time I'll be there in person, on the comms, with the team. And I'm nervous. I'm excited, but I'm nervous at the same time. So I thought to expel some of those nerves, I'm going to talk about the event that's happening this Saturday on the 28th at the Ardler Complex. For those that are unaware, you can get your tickets. They are still available. You can get them at faircitywrestling.com. There's a nice little buy tickets link. Takes you to Eventbrite. Sorted. Go get yourself a ticket. Doors are open 6:30, bell time 7 p.m. There'll be plenty on offer at the Ardler Complex on Saturday for Fair City Wrestling. And I'm just going to go and tell you what's happening. But before we get that, this has been a year in the making. Last year, ArdlerMania, there were some incredible matches, incredible moments, an incredible main event as well. And here we are a year later, just a year and a week, I think, year and a week later at ArdlerMania Part Deux. And it's all going to go up. It's going to go excited. It's going to be an exciting place. I've got a long history with the Ardler Complex itself when it comes to being a fan of wrestling, getting involved in the Scottish wrestling scene. I've done some jobs in that building. I've been ring announcer in that building. But now I am there, going to be calling the action, best seat of the house on comms. I'm yet to find out, I've yet to confirm who I'll be sitting with. Hearing some rumblings that there's possibly going to be a certain wooden spoon winner will be sitting next to me, but we'll find out on the day, I'm sure. I've got my notes. I've started. I'm just going to turn around and get it. Got my notepad all sorted. I have started writing notes for things, just like bits and pieces of information, so I don't forget it, really, because I have a terrible memory, as you're going to find out in a moment when I talk about the six matches that have been confirmed for this event. And if you check out any other previous preview podcasts I do, there is a moment where I just look blankly and stare in the screen, just going, I've forgotten all the words in the world. But we're going to do it. I'm going to get there. Trust me, I'm going to get there. So for those that don't listen to the SWN podcast, don't listen to the WrestleZone podcast, don't listen to All About the Discord, you're just here for the Fair City Wrestling content in general. So we've covered Fair City Wrestling since its inception on the SWN website. It's swnscotland.com. I've only been to one show, which was last year's ArdlerMania, but we do check out FCW Empire, which is available on Fair City Wrestling's YouTube channel. The plan is I'm going to start like writing them up as well, do a bit of reviews when they go out a couple of days after the events air on YouTube. So we're going to have full steam ahead on Fair City Wrestling content on the SWN website. So we have been a proud supporter of Fair City Wrestling, along with a lot of companies in Scotland. I'm looking forward to doing a bit more of my part and being able to sit there and hopefully be, I'm going to use this line on commentary because I've wrote it down and I thought, I'm using that line. I'm hoping to be a bit more lyrical like Art Garfunkel and less like Art Donovan. So we're going to have a good time on Saturday 28th. I'm going to travel down. I'm using all the transport. I've got a bus, I've got a car, I've got a train on the way back up. So there's going to be plenty of transport, planes, trains and automobiles on the way down, definitely using that trade card to full effect. So I'm looking forward to it. Let's just get into it. I'm too excited, too amped up. Let's just talk about this full card. Let's do it. So to ease myself into this preview, we're going to talk about the Fair City Rumble title, Over the Top Rope Gauntlet. It's all going well. Fair City Rumble spot. So the winner of this Over the Top Gauntlet will be able to pick their number for the Fair City Rumble, which will take place at the Tulloch Institute on October 11th, as tickets are available on faircitywrestling.com. So you can get your tickets for that, you get to see a Rumble. Like, Rumbles are the best. Rumbles are just the best kind of matches. But the entrants that have been confirmed for this, we've got the Dap Dub. There you go, Patrick. That's for you. That's just specifically for you. The Dap Dub champion, Jay Robin, got Bochico, Rich Money, Retro Randy Valentine, Tommy Raiden, Ollie Green, Sam McMillan, king of the class at the moment at Dap Dub. Oh, that pains me. Samuel and Valak as well from Red Gate. So this is a stacked gauntlet. Now, when it's over the top gauntlet, I'm assuming it's one in, one out. That's how I'm saying it in my mind, or I don't know if it's going to be more like a preview for the Fair City Rumble, and we've got a mini Royal Rumble going on, a mini Fair City Rumble going on where people will come in at defined intervals. But I'll find out at the time. But I'm prepared. I've got my notes prepared. Don't you worry. So previous winners have included Yuji Maki and Dicky Divers. Both went on to become Fair City Wrestling Heavyweight Champion. So this is the first step. Possibly a career-altering moment, a career-altering. If you win this match, then surely, it's gonna take a lot for you just to go, yeah, I'm gonna pick number one. We saw Tom Atlas do that, and he, hey, fair play to Tom. He got to the end. He just about did it. But it takes a lot of guts to do that. You should, personally, you go last. You know, you let everyone weaken themselves to get. They get all like yeah. Just go all weekend and then just go. Yeah, I'm taking that number, please. I'll have number 30 or 25 or however many numbers it is in the Fair City Rumble. I think it's 30. So you'd obviously pick 30, right? So let's break down who's in this. So with Jay Robin, like I said, Dap Dub champion. He's over at Dundee and Angus Pro Wrestling. I've been holding that title for a couple months now, and he's been putting in the work to earn his spots in this particular match. My interesting take on this is I mentioned who's won that match in the past, the Fair City Rumble, including Yuji Maki. I mean, these winners will gain the Game Changer briefcase. So that's the prize here. This is the long game here. You win this match, you pick your spot, you win the Game Changer briefcase. You get a guaranteed title match any time of your choosing. So Jay Robin's got a little bit of a past history with Yuji Maki. Will there'll be some advice where will Mackie be able to impart some wisdom on Jay Robin for this match as this little aperitif for the Fair City Rumble? I mean, you would think possibly all these guys may appear in the Fair City Rumble anyway, but it's more about guaranteeing their actual spot in that match. Bochico, if I remember rightly, had a fantastic run last year. He came very close to winning it all. Unfortunately, Dicky Divers found a way to punt out Bochico right at the end. I could be misremembering. I'm sure someone will correct me if I'm wrong. So he's got the experience in the Fair City Rumble. He knows how to throw people over the top rope. He knows how to survive. That's the most important thing does Bochico, especially since he's kind of evolved from the happy-go-lucky he falls over. Ha ha. He's now a wrestler. You know, he's learned through things like Yuji Maki's School of Rejected Luchadors. He's learned. I mean, that's you and again mentioned. Do you think that, again, Bochico might look to try and get some advice from Yuji Maki, a former winner of the Fair City Rumble? Gotta think about that. Rich Money, he came in with a silver spoon in his mouth, and then Ian Ambrose stuck it somewhere else. So Rich Money hasn't had much luck when it comes to winning at the moment, but he's still got plenty of moolah thrown around to get the opportunities. So will he be able to flash some cash? Will he be able to get a couple rounds through this gauntlet? If he just maybe flashes some money, he might do that. Who knows? Retro Randy Valentine, when you look at who's in this match, the man with the most experience, the one who's won battle royals, the one who's been in plenty of battle royal matches in the past over the course of his career across the territories. He's done it all in professional wrestling, and he is gunning for this. I've seen social media posts. He's looking just to throw people body after body after body, and he's going to win this match, go on to the Fair City Rumble, where he made his return, his triumphant return, not long ago. I think it was 2023 edition. I think he made his return. It must be 2023. Made his return to the Fair City faithful. Made his return to wrestling during that night as well, and it makes all the sense to the world that we're going to see Retro Randy Valentine move on, pick his spot. He's a wily veteran. He knows that last number, that's the one you want. You know, he's not gonna not going to shy away from that. I think you'd be silly to think otherwise. Randy Valentine would be going in number last number. He wants to be the final man standing and do that, getting through this over the top gauntlet as well. A couple of debuts we've got for Fair City Wrestling. First up is Tommy Raiden, who people may know through you made an appearance at Dab Dub. Oh, it kills my soul. Dab Dab. But I'm doing this for you, Patrick. This is all for you. Tommy Raiden made his debut at Dab Dab, and so he'll be a bit more familiar with those in the Fair City Wrestling community. Tommy Raiden up from the Northeast. He's obviously I know him very well, along with the other debutant, which I'll speak about in a second. Tommy Raiden is got a lot of heart, a lot of fight. He's been mentored by the likes of Mickey Vago, some veterans up in the Northeast scene as well. He's had a lot of big opponents as well. It's this guy that's fought bravely, didn't ultimately come up with the win, but he's faced the likes of Bruiser Brad Evans. You know, he's faced the likes of Dino. He's faced big lads in the Northeast, and he's looking to try and overcome that hurdle. If he's overcame that hurdle, he's still around after 2 years, then I think he's going to be a survivor. He's going to do his best to try and survive in this particular match, in this over the top rope gauntlet. The other debutant is Ollie Green, Oliver Green. He goes by, I'm so used to calling him Ollie Green because his chant is Ollie, Ollie, Ollie. Oi, oi, oi. And this is a guy I'm very excited for to see, because Ollie Green, I've seen wrestle pretty much since the start now. It's been a couple of years. He made his debut in a Rumble match. It was the Regal Rumble. I made his debut in that particular match. So he didn't last long. I'm just hoping he keeps his jacket on so we can see it this time, because he got too excited and whipped it off and nobody got to see it. So hoping we get to see more of Ollie Green. Interestingly enough, last year at ArdlerMania, Ollie Green was in the crowd watching this show. So he's scouted his opponents. He has scouted these guys at Fair City Wrestling. He's been there. He's kept an eye on these people. I mean, all the people that are in this match, only Retro Randy was in a match, but that doesn't mean we've got access to footage on things like FCW Empire and Patreon. Last year's ArdlerMania event is on Patreon if you want to go and find it on Fair City Wrestling's Patreon channel. The game costs like a couple quid, $4.99 maybe, and you get to watch it. It's a cracking show. I've done a review on it. It's on the website. So yeah, Ollie Green, I think, is an interesting. He's making his debut, his actual debut for Fair City Wrestling. Hasn't been seen before. He hasn't done Dap Dub shows, as far as I'm aware. But he's got that Rumble experience as well. As is Tommy. Tommy's done a Rumble or two as well. I think he's I remember watching him win a Rumble at Trinity Centre in Aberdeen. So he knows how to do it. He knows how to throw people over the top rope. It's just a case of is the fact that he's going to be in a busy venue, in a big bustling venue, a new venue. That's probably more important. A new venue like the Ardler Complex. He's been in packed arenas like Rich Energy Arena, been in packed venues as well. So that possibly won't be as much of a pressure, but certainly a new face in the crowd is seeing a new crowd as well in front of him. Could that play a factor for Tommy and for Ollie Green? I'm excited to see what they do. It's great because, I mean, as far as notes go, I know a lot about Randy. Seen plenty about J. Robin, a bit about Bochico, but guys like Tommy Raiden and Oliver Green, out of the guys that will probably be on the commentary booth, these will be the guys that I'll probably have a little bit more of an edge of information on as well. So I'm looking forward to speaking about the guys from the Northeast, because you know everyone thinks I've got a Northeast bias, and I am not doing very much to prove it wrong. But elsewhere in this match, in this over the top rope gauntlet, we've got King of the Class Sam McMillan, Pretty Boy Sam McMillan, who's currently who's kind of noticed on social media. He's been kind of working through some concussion protocol. He's been working on trying to get himself ready for this match itself. But the King of the Class, that's how he won. How to become King of the Class was winning a battle royal. So he's got that maybe recent experience edge on battle royals in comparison to everyone else, getting somebody over the top rope, being wily and trying to make sure that they are the last man standing. So Sam McMillan, he's got the edge, maybe, possibly. Retro Randy, of course, has the experience over everyone. Tom Brady and Ollie got that unknown factor about him, especially Ollie, because he's not wrestled at all in Fair City or in Dap Dub. So there's a lot of moving parts in this that people could pick apart and pick that could be their way forward. Like J. Robin being the Dub champion. We've got Bochico, who's done well in Bear City Rumbles in the past. He's come close, but no cigar. Elsewhere, last two entrants is Samuel and Valak from Redgate. A tag team, you know, if this is the case of intervals going in, then surely Samuel and Valak will have an advantage in that respect because they'll be able to form a team. Interesting thing with this is if, say, Samuel throws out Rich Money, you know, and it's over the top, if it's gauntlet style, as title suggests, what if next person is Valak? What if Samuel and Valak have to, like, interact and one of them will have to move on and move forward in the gauntlet? Or if it's the final two, we get to see Samuel and Valak. I'm losing my voice. Samuel and Valak battle it out. I apologize to anyone listening to this that have just had me shout Samuel so often. But, you know, Samuel is in this match. So, and I'm blaming Randy for that particular one after interviewing him for the podcast, for the SWN podcast. Because he kept calling Samuel, and it's now just kind of forever stuck in my brain. So apologies. So that's the entrance confirmed for the Fair City Rumble spot over the top rope gauntlet. Easy for me to say. I kind of pick a favorite. You mean you got, like I said, there's so many factors that you can throw in there. The championship experience, recent championship experience of J. Robin as Dub champion, Retro Randy of that experience edge over everyone, the unknown factor of Ollie and Tommy, Rich Money. Be able to get some monetary monetaries. That's not a word. That's not a phrase. That's not right. I'll move on. Sam McMillan, of course, the recent say of winning the King of the Class, and Samuel and Valak being a team as Redgate. Will they have a plan together as well? Because no doubt Eden will be ringside for either or both as well. So she'll be a factor. No doubt in this particular style of match. Whew, that was a lot to pack in that little segment, but I'm excited. I love a rumble. I'm not ashamed to say it. I love a rumble, and I'm going to get to call a rumble match at ArdlerMania Part Deux at the Ardler Complex. Get your ticket for this. If you're going to, there's so many good matches that we're going to speak about, and I've already covered this one. This is the only one I've covered so far. I feel like I've talked forever. So we're going to cover the rest of the matches now, and we'll move on. But yeah, get your tickets. FairCityWrestling.com. Click the link, buy tickets. Eventbrite, go get them, because this is going to be an absolute stellar event. Let's move on to the rest of the card. I'm absolutely knackered already. I've only done one match. Now I've calmed myself down with a little drink of Moose Juice, which we do have a discount code now, SWN10. Go to Moose Juice, and you can get 10% off. Most packs. I think the only thing that you can't get a discount off of is like the daily deals, juicy deals, you know, which is already heavily discounted. So 10% off your order, SWN10. Anyway, Arthur Complex will see a grudge match. And once again, it is involving Marcus the Glory Hunter. Last year, he got ousted from Fair City Wrestling by losing a 4-on-4 elimination bout. And this year, he is drawn the ire of Patrick Patierski for whatever reason. Patrick, of course, was very vocal about Marcus the Glory Hunter and the rest, and Sebastian Asher and everyone that was involved, and Omar Muhammad, everyone was involved with Glory Hunting agencies when he was on the commentary desk with Randy at the time. So there's a little bit of bitterness there, I'm sure, from Marcus the Glory Hunter, who returned under a mask, under the guise of El Tremendo. He gained the trust of Keir Douglas. He gained the trust of Patrick Patierski. They went to All In together at Wembley. They shared moments, they shared time together. They built this circle of trust. No, they did this. And suddenly Keir's disappeared. And El Tremendo turned his back. Not even turned his back. He kicked the front of Patrick Patierski a couple of weeks ago at the Tulloch Institute, revealed himself to be Marcus the Glory Hunter. And this is a guy that Patrick would have had in his home when they were recording the previous edition of the SWN podcast, sorry, Fair City Wrestling podcast, apologies, FCW podcast. it was El Tremendo that was on that episode, and yeah, it made Patrick look like a fool. You know, it looked like he let this man into his home. He trusted El Tremendo, and El Tremendo turned out to be Marcus the Glory Hunter, who has spent the last year just getting himself ready, just looking for a victim, it seems, looking for a way to worm himself back into Fair City Wrestling. He did it by defeating Body Guy Brandon a couple of weeks ago, and then he didn't even wait. You know, he didn't care to give it another month. I think he wanted that ArdlerMania match. He wanted to have the biggest crowd he could possibly have to see his official debut in the ring as Marcus the Glory Hunter in one-on-one form with this. He's been doing the training. He's been doing the one-on-one training. He clearly has put in the work. But it's a case of the way he's done it. The way he's wormed himself back into Fair City Wrestling under the guise of El Tremendo. The guy that he infiltrated Not Safe for Mums. He did all this in such a sleazy way that he's found himself in a match at ArdlerMania. It's worked. You can't deny his tactics. You can judge his tactics, but you can't deny his tactics. He's found his way into a marquee match at ArdlerMania Part 2. I think this is the only non-title singles match on this show. So it's a marquee match. That's it. You got Marcus the Glory Hunter and Patrick Patierski. Patrick, he last time at ArdlerMania, he had to watch from the commentary booth, and he witnessed Marcus the Glory Hunter lose his company, lose Fair City Wrestling that he took over, thanks to some family funds. So to see this kind of this story work its way back around to Part 2, be very interesting, very exciting indeed. We've seen what Patrick Patierski can do, but we haven't really seen what Marcus the Glory Hunter can do. He had his match with Body Guy Brandon under the El Tremendo mask. So it's a case of finding out on what we're going to see, what we're going to witness when Marcus the Glory Hunter officially makes his singles debut as a fully fledged wrestler on the roster. Patrick Patierski, like I said, Karen Douglas, the Not Safe for Mums tag team partner, has been a bit quiet. He's not been around as often. Will he be alone? Will Patrick have to call on some Not Safe for Mums army? I don't know what to call them. The Patierskis. No. The Pat Bitches. No, that's terrible. Let's move on. It's not that dumb, is it? This is going to be an interesting grudge match for Marcus the Glory Hunter taking on Patrick Patierski. Patrick, he wants his hands on Marcus. Marcus has been sly and sleek it in avoiding contact with Patrick, booking training sessions after Patrick leaves, doing all this kind of things. I think it's just to further make this moment at ArdlerMania even bigger. And if Hunter wins, God help us. And not the fact that he wouldn't have a say in management, the fact that if he picks up a win over Patrick Patierski, that's two wins. He's starting to build up. That's the way to gain notoriety, gain traction, gain championships possibly in the future as well. So both men need this win. It's a case of, will Patrick be able to keep level-headed enough to keep that bucket hat nice and safe and sound on his head, keep himself level-headed, or is he just going to just tear apart Marcus the Glory Hunter? And I mean, what other tricks is Marcus Hunter hiding beneath that sleeveless top? Let's move on. Now let's get into the championship matches. We have lots. We've got four championship matches announced for the show as of recording. And there's four championships in FCW, so I'm assuming that's going to be all of them. First up, we're going to talk about the FCW Tag Team Championships are on the line. Which is Sebastian Asher and Duke Cannon, they seem to be going by Duke and Asher now. Cool. They will be defending against Casino Brutal, Rabu, and Mikey Divine. I am so excited for this as a fan itself, because I've been such a big fan of Casino Brutal for a long time now, and I get to see them wrestle live for the first time, and I'll be calling the match as well. So I'll be excited to see what Rabu and Mikey Devine get up to in a tables match environment. The Fair City Wrestling Tag Team Champions, they've battled back a lot of like weighty challengers, you know? They've been able to survive with that title reign intact. Duke walked into last year's ArdlerMania as tag team champion also, with Nathan North. So he's not shy in returning to the Ardler complex with a title in hand. Sebastian Asher was a junior heavyweight title match last year as well. So again, these guys have got championship credentials out the wazoo when it comes to the Ardler complex, certainly. They'll be taking on Excuse Brutality rematch from a couple of weeks ago at the Tulloch Institute. Now, I haven't seen the footage as yet, but I'm hearing there was plenty of shenanigans involved. This match was brought upon, the initial match was brought upon Mikey Devine winning a triple threat bout to earn his team a title opportunity. Like I said, I haven't seen the footage yet, so I don't know what DE got up to. I'm sure it'll be out between now and Friday. I was hoping there was going to be an Empire episode yesterday, but maybe it's going to be later today, and all the stuff I'm saying looks obsolete and silly because it's going to come out on Wednesday. But the take on Casino Brutal, a team that have probably they've got a lot of experience, possibly a little bit more than Duke and Asher together. Well, certainly together. Although we've established in previous chats and previous interviews through the FCW podcast and the SWN podcast that Duke and Asher have a long history together since near the beginning of Fair City Wrestling and before that. So they've known each other for quite a while, even though their collaborative team didn't form until very recently. But Casino Brutal, they've got experience in things like chairs matches, street fights. They've won tag team gold elsewhere as well, so they know how to win titles. And it's going to be a case, and they're busy. You know, they've I think last week they were in Liverpool, then Glasgow. They've traveled around, and the Duke and Asher, they are mainly situated in Fair City Wrestling, but in that respect as well, they know that place inside and out. They know the Ardler Complex, they know the Tulloch Institute, they know all these places inside and out. They know where the nooks and crannies are to get an advantage. They know that ring 100% as well. They know every fold and nick and hardest part of that ring as well, which will be an advantage certainly for weakening a Casino Brutal to put them through a table as well. I guess say a tables match, man. I'm so excited for that. But to go and see Casino Brutal, Rabu, and Mikey Devine in action at the Ardler Complex. Duke and Asher, like I said, they've along with Tom Atlas and Spike Tierney, they've been doing their utmost to run Fair City Wrestling recently. When ArdlerMania Part Deux was announced, I was even thinking, are we going to see another big Survivors match again? But no, we've got tag team titles on the line. Duke and Asher will defend against Casino Brutal, which is surefire going to be an absolute banger of a match. I'm excited for it. I'm not even hiding it. I'm excited for this. I'm excited for all these matches, and I'm going to get to see and get to call as well. So it's going to be a fantastic night. FaircityWrestling.com. Get your ticket. I'm just going to keep plugging it. We're selling this out. We're selling this show out. You know, I'm telling you, you're in the Dundee area. Get a ticket. Go to the Ardler Complex. It's a bus ride from the centre. It's like a £3 bus. Fine, go for it. Get yourself a damn ticket. So anyway, Ardler Complex, tag team titles on the line. This is going to be an absolute chaotic match, a tables match. I'm going to be darting my eyes all over the place. I'm going to be praying that the lighting's like a little bit lighter than last year. It was really dark last year, which was fantastic and atmospheric. But I need to see some of the match, so I'm hoping it's a little bit more up. So tech team, John, turn lights up. So I'm looking forward to this one. So let's look into the other. I've said that many times, haven't I? So we'll look into the other title matches we've got coming up. Speaking of DE, we've got Spike Tierney defending the FCW Junior Heavyweight Championship against TikTok megastar Ravy Davey. Ravy Davey will be making his debut at the Ardler Complex, and he'll be taking on the Fair City Wrestling Junior Heavyweight Champion, Spike Tierney, who's held that title for near 600 days. He has battled back the many challenges on his way. He has ended up forming, along with Asher, Duke, and Atlas, and DE during that reign as well. He's done a lot of things. He's faced a lot of opponents, big and small, during that reign. And likes of Duke and Asher, likes of Atlas as well. He's been able to defend against his older brothers before they were brothers. He's defended against Zachary Swift, Yuji Maki, former FCW champion. He's defended against Nitro Green. Those shady circumstances, from what I've been told and what I've been informed of, there wasn't a totally what's the word? Kosher? Is that a word? Oh, that. In circumstances, but the defense still is still noted in the record books. He still defeated Nitro Green and retained the FCW Junior Heavyweight Championship. He has had this title for near 600 days. It looks like nobody's going to beat him. That nobody's got a chance. And we've got Ravy Davey, who's in the Central Belt, is won more titles than I can think of at this moment in time. He's won plenty of belts. He's been around. He's wrestled in some of the biggest venues in the country. He's had so many big viral moments, whether it's on his own TikTok channel, food reviews, or whether it's in the wrestling ring being thrown off ladders and going through tables. So Ravy Davey is a hustler. He has hustled his way to a championship match on the first time of asking as well for the Junior Heavyweight Championship against Spike Tierney. This is going to be a high-flying contest. This is going to be, when you see the side by side, Spike Tierney and Ravy Davey, possibly the last thing you're thinking it's going to be a high-flying contest, but there's going to be bodies everywhere in this one. There's going to be some springboards and other things. Can't think of another word after springboards. This is going well. So it's going to be a cracking match. It's going to be very fun to watch. Whether it's going to be fun for either or, if they're going to be seeing bodies thrown at them, that's another matter. The other thing with Ravy Davey is he's got to look out for the rest of DE. Whether Atlas is going to be able to walk if his knees healed enough for him to be involved a bit more than possibly just shouting at ringside, or if Duke and Asher will get involved as well. There's going to be eyes at the back of his head, does Ravy Davey, if he wants to become Varsity Wrestling Junior Heavyweight Champion. That's the long and short of it. He's got to do that. He's got to make sure that he's got his back covered. I don't know if he's going to have Xander with him. He's going to have Steg with him. If he's going to have the Govan team involved in protecting Ravy Davey from the rest of DE. But Davey's done it alone before. He has fought many things in his lifetime. So he'll just have to make sure he can fight back the rest of DE for the Junior Heavyweight Championship. Tough one to call. You know, like I say, Spike Tierney's reached that 600 days. Ravy Davey's coming in with a lot of energy, a lot of just work that he's put in to get opportunities, get to places, and like I say, that hustle mentality that he has. We could see a dark horse match of the night here between Spike Tierney and Ravy Davey. It's going to be a very interesting contest. I've got notes. I'm looking forward to busting out for this particular match. I'm looking forward to seeing how Ravy Davey's reception is at the Ardler Complex as well, because it's a big echoey venue. There's going to be a lot of noise in this match, whether it's going to be against Spike Tierney or for Ravy Davey, but it's going to be a loud night. It's going to be a loud match at the Ardler Complex on Saturday the 28th. I'm excited. Excited for this one. It's ArdlerMania Part 2. We've got Brody Adler defending the FCW Women's Championship against Moxie Malone. Another match that I'm absolutely buzzing for. Like, all these matches on this card, but Moxie Malone has been someone that I've wanted to see wrestle for a long time. She's won one of our one to watch trophies in the past, as well as Casino Brutal, so I've remembered to pack them. So, you know, got to have these bad boys out. Moxie Malone, who the Misfit, who has been forming our Moxie crew elsewhere at the moment, is one of those, just an animal in the ring. You know, she just scraps and claws and just is relentless in the ring. She will just keep fighting and biting at you to keep you down. She'll gnaw. She's just an absolute animal. I've overused the word pit bull recently in things, but I'm going to use it again. The absolute pit bull of just grabbing a body part and just wailing on it and just making sure that you know of Moxie Malone's presence. It's going up against Brody Adler versus ArdlerMania again. She won last year. She's been undefeated at the Ardler Complex and looking to continue that as FCW Women's Champion She won that title recently using their Game Changer briefcase, and she became the FCW Women's Champion. Defended it numerous times against numerous opponents, like some Molly Spartan, like Kate Calloway. Plenty of defenses going into this match. Plenty of momentum gained as well for Brody Adler. Moxie Malone defeated Kate Galloway. Calloway. I threw in a G for some reason. Apologies, Kate. Kate Calloway there to become number one contender for this title. And Moxie is just not going to be her first match for the FCW Women's Championship. She's had four attempts. This will be her fourth attempt at that title. And it'll be maybe fourth time lucky, perhaps, for Moxie Malone for the Misfit. But this is a nice, this is an interesting combo, a clash of styles, perhaps. We've got Brody Adler, who relies on the power, maybe some deceptive agility thrown in there as well. And Moxie Malone is just an absolute pure brawler. But she's got a little bit of a tech side to her. She looks to employ that dragon sleeper to pick up submission wins. So if Brody's able to avoid the dragon sleeper, she might be able to retain the title as well. Whereas Moxie Malone is going to have to maybe just dip, dive, and dodge if she wants to try and wear Brody down to get that dragon sleeper in. A lot of things going on here. Moxie Malone has been under the guidance of the likes of Casey, likes of Molly Spartan in the past as well. So she's got a lot of ADM, who's also on the show, which is the last match I'll speak about. It'll be his match. She's got a lot. She's had a lot of people in her ear. They've given her advice over the years. Brody Adler, the same as well. Just some different people, including ADM, funnily enough. He's got a lot of voices in ears. I don't know how that's a terrible phrase. We'll move on. But yeah, Brody Adler and Moxie Malone, I'm excited for this FCW Women's Championship match. The fact that we're getting to see Moxie at the Adler Complex, we're going to see ArdlerMania Part 2 as well. Oh, it's going to be fantastic. I'm looking forward to it, and you should be too. So yeah, Clash of Styles, like I say, power against the brawling. We'll just have to see if which one just wears through, which one able survives out of the two styles. There's not been a lot of social media at the moment about it. Moxie Malone, check out our social media, same with Brody. I'm sure they'll have some words about it before Saturday about this upcoming match at the Ardler Complex, because yeah, it's what I'm excited for. Now, I feel like I've just talked the hind legs off a donkey, so I'm gonna maybe not keep this brief, but this is the last match. Fair City Wrestling Heavyweight Championship will be decided. There'll be a new champion crowned when Alexander Darwin McCallion, ADM, will take on Ian Ambrose, the hashtag scumbag, the infamous one himself, to crown a new champion. Nicky Divers vacated the title a couple of months back. The decision then at that point was Ian Ambrose and Caleb Valhalla would determine, it was already determined they would determine the number one contender for ArdlerMania, which Ian Ambrose won. And then it was decided that Ian Ambrose would be one half of a match at ArdlerMania for the championship. Again, footage hasn't been out yet for it, as far as I'm aware, but ADM answered, well, mysteriously. It was ruddy mysterious, to be honest. He accepted the latter half. The match was made. Looks like it's rattled Ian Ambrose a little bit through social media, and that he's ready for this particular match with ADM. I mean, it's so interesting. I'm just looking at my notes here because there's plenty of things I want to kind of pick up about this. Ian Ambrose is a former FCW heavyweight champion. He's won gold in that venue at the Ardor Complex before. He retained the title last year against Emerson Jane in that venue. He's got a lot of history with the Ardor Complex. The ADM doesn't, you know. His history, ADM's history with the Ardor Complex, is losing that elimination bout at ArdlerMania last year. So he's coming to this with a loss. He spent last year with hatred in his heart for Caleb Valhalla, and now he's got to turn his attention to Ian Ambrose. I'm interested to think that ADM was hoping he would get Caleb, because it was the opportunity, the potential opponents for ADM for this match, for this title, was going to be Ian Ambrose or Caleb Valhalla. Ian defeated Caleb to move on to this match. I'm interested to think if ADM had to repurpose his strategy, his thoughts, and how he was going to work things, because he was hoping he'd get one final showdown with Caleb Valhalla at the Ardor Complex. because we, I still feel like there's going to be a definitive end. They're always going to be marching around and circling each other and finding ways to try and get their hands on the other. But we haven't. I don't feel like we've had a definitive end. I could be totally wrong. Apologize if I forget a match somewhere. So ADM and Ian Ambrose. ADM, of course, tall, big. Gonna throw people. He's gonna toss you like yesterday's jab. He's gonna just throw you around. Ian Ambrose, he's got such a hybrid style. He can throw in some tech. He can throw in some flying. He can throw in some brawling. He can just take you down a road, whatever road he wants to take you down. He'll have Scully in hand, I'm sure, to guide him in this particular match. Also, it's hard to bet against the infamous Ian Ambrose, but if there's one guy that can come in and disrupt anything, disrupt just the whole hierarchy and nature of Fair City Wrestling, it's ADM. ADM is a interesting figure in wrestling. He's a tall dude, but he's able to kind of move smoothly. So he kind of floats around, you know. So to see him and Ian Ambrose clash is going to be, it's going to be exciting. It's going to be fun. The fact that I mentioned earlier by people that have been under the guidance of ADM, Moxie Malone is on this show, who of course was part of ADM's manifesto previously. So I'm interested to see if there's any interaction there that could possibly assist ADM further in this match to win his first FCW Heavyweight Championship. ADM's no stranger to titles though. He was a long reigning Source Heavyweight Champion. I think it's called the Source Championship. The long reigning Source Wrestling Champion. He knows what it takes to become a champion. He knows what it takes to hold on to that title for a long time as well. So if he's coming in to become Fair City Wrestling Champion, we could be in for a long reign on our hands here. Ian Ambrose, like I say, he's looking to become a two-time FCW champion. The only other person that's done that, to my memory, is Caleb Valhalla. But you know, I am a professional. And I will check as well. So FCW Heavyweight Championship, yep, Caleb Valhalla. He was the inaugural champion in 2021. Then won the title again about 18 months later as well. Dickie Divers, he vacated it back in August. So that title has been sitting dormant for the last month, waiting for a new champion to hold it, to get its hands and their name to the nameplate on the side of the belt. It's a beautiful belt. So it's exciting time. It's exciting time in Fair City Wrestling. And we're going to find, if you can guarantee anything on this night, there's four championships matches. We're guaranteed to get one new champion at the very least. It's going to be this match, the main event, ADM versus Ian Ambrose. I'm buzzing. I'm buzzing. Let's do some the roundup while you're still listening. Tickets are available at faircitywrestling.com. Go get your tickets Saturday, 28th of September. Doors open 6:30. Get your butts to the Ardler Complex. There are six banging matches that have been announced. I'll be there. I'll be on commentary. I'll be sitting talking about the action to everyone that listens. I'm looking forward to speaking about this show. I'm looking forward to being on the show. I'm looking forward to meeting the wrestlers again and getting to call their matches and do what they do best. And I'll just sit there and hope I do a pretty good job. If you haven't got a ticket already, go get one. It's going to be a great night at the Ardor Complex, a venue that has rich history of superstars and titles, opportunities and matches and moments. And you could be there as well on Saturday on the 28th of September. So you should be. Go do it. Go do it. Go get a ticket. I have been your host, co-commentator. I'm going to call myself that for this particular podcast. Co-commentator, Billy Strachan. I have taken over the FCW podcast. We'll be back to normal services being resumed, probably for Fair City Rumble with Patrick and Will and Kieran, hopefully as well. If Marcus the Glory Hunter has been able to release him to from whatever place he's been hidden, but I'm excited. Thank you for the guys at the FCW podcast for allowing me to take over for this particular episode. I hope that I haven't bored you too much. I've talked about exciting matches. How can you be bored? Go get your ticket, ffbristlywrestling.com. Go get your ticket for September 28th. It's ArdlerMania Part Deux. I'm excited. You should be excited. Let's go enjoy some wrestling together. I don't know how to sign this off. How do we sign these off? We usually just fade out. We fade out. That's how we usually work these things. Yeah, we fade out, and then I end up talking about some sort of nonsense, and that's how that works out. And then the music kicks in, and then I hope for the best. So we're gonna try that. We're gonna try and do that. We're gonna try and just let it fade away. Just let it fade away. Let it fade away. That's what we do. Yeah. Dab dub. Dab dub. Dab dub.